Thank you and good morning. We urge everyone in Hurricane Michael's path to be ready to shelter in place, stay off the water, stay clear of beaches, and heed all safety messages and evacuation orders from state and local authorities. Social media is great for resources to follow updates, but do not use social media to report emergencies. Please call 911 or use VHF Channel 16. Our priorities are the safety of our responders, their families, and the public. Once the storm has passed, hazards may still be present. Stay in a safe location while the Coast Guard and other state and local authorities assess damages and disperse additional resources. Thank you.
Good morning. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers South Atlantic Division is coordinating closely with FEMA Region 4, and of course we're coordinating closely here in D.C. To provide any support that is required. Thank you.
Hola, buenos días. Soy Daniel Yargués de FEMA, portavoz de FEMA. Queremos informarles que esperamos que esta tormenta sea de gran magnitud y que traiga fuertes vientos. Como lo dijo nuestro socio del Servicio Nacional de Meteorología, se esperan vientos de hasta 100 millas por hora, que se alcance una categoría de 3. Esto es una tormenta de gran magnitud. Entonces, las recomendaciones que les damos, por favor, hagan caso y acaten a las órdenes de sus autoridades locales, ya que si tienen que evacuar, si tienen que irse de esa área, por favor, háganlo. También se espera que la marejada ciclónica alcance en unos lugares hasta 12 pies. Entonces, va a traer también muchísima lluvia, agua y olas muy fuertes. Conocer esas rutas de evacuación es importante. Como lo dijo el administrador asociado Jeff Beyer, que por favor también descarguen la aplicación de FEMA, ya que pueden obtener información de refugio si necesitan ir a un refugio y también alertas de las condiciones del tiempo del Servicio Nacional de Meteorología. Es el momento para hacerlo. Podemos hacerlo hoy, ya que se espera que esta tormenta toque tierra para mañana alrededor del mediodía. Entonces, por favor, hagan caso a eso y descarguen la aplicación para recibir esta información. Nosotros aquí en FEMA estamos trabajando con nuestros socios en Florida, en Alabama, en Georgia. Ya tenemos equipos de FEMA desplazados en estos centros de operaciones para poder apoyar y ayudar en las necesidades que puedan tener. También nuestras oficinas aquí en FEMA tenemos equipos y ya estamos activados al 100% para poder apoyar las necesidades que se puedan dar. Tenemos también suministros a la mano para poder apoyar las necesidades de los estados impactados. Y también les pedimos que esperen interrupción de servicios de agua, de electricidad, de gas, porque bueno, esta tormenta trae muchos vientos, agua, marejada ciclónica, y lo importante en este momento es evacuar, acatar esas órdenes de evacuación y descargar la aplicación de FEMA para recibir información de lo que está sucediendo. Gracias. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you talk a little bit about any sites that might be in the hurricane's path that have you concerned or preparing in any way? I know in North Carolina with Florence, there were some sites that were nuclear power plants that were a concern. Is there anything similar with this past storm?
You know, our main concern now is the safety of the citizens, and we urge that anybody that needs to evacuate, evacuate. Obviously, we'll continue to assess as the storm gets closer to landfall. It's a large, area that's currently under a hurricane surge warning. So we'll continue to monitor all that and then obviously be ready to support our local and state efforts. But our main concern now is just the evacuation of our citizens that are in danger. Yes, ma'am.
Has preparing for this storm been different than, say, a Hurricane Florence, where we had a lot more of, a preview as to what was to come? As in with this one, it's really just kind of popped up pretty suddenly.
You know, every storm is different. This is just a great illustration of that. I wish every storm was the same and we could prepare the same way. Obviously, there's benefits to having more time because you have more time to warn our citizens of the danger. Also with this one, though, you also have limited time, which causes you to act more and act more decisive, which is good. And I believe we're doing that very, very well. We've been monitoring the storm or the disturbance, for a couple of days. But you're right, this rapidly intensifying storm always presents a challenge. But, the state of Florida obviously is no stranger to hurricanes. The Gulf Coast is no stranger to hurricanes. We have some of the best emergency managers in the nation that are prepared for this. We have some of the best first responders in the nation prepared for this. The Florida National Guard is one of the top guards that we have in our nation. and our states surrounding there ready to support. So when you put the whole family together, you know, whether it's 4 days or a couple of days, we're prepared and we're ready for whatever Michael may throw our way. Yes, sir.
Greg Wallace from CNN. With Florence, a few weeks ago, we saw a lot of flooding. Can you tell us what to expect with this storm and what the, you know, the, what the challenges to reestablishing those lifelines will be?
So, you know, again, looking at a crystal ball that may not, hopefully we're wrong, but with this storm, what I would say, you're going to see a traditional powerful hurricane strike, very fast moving, high surge, and very, very powerful winds. So you'll see more power outages, and probably the damage to the power infrastructure is going to be more significant than Florence, because it will be down power lines and poles. So it will take a little more time to restore. But again, Florida Power and Light and the other crews that are coming in are very, very adept to doing that. You're going to see more localized impact with the surge, where you saw a lot more inland, miles and miles inland flooding with Florence. I will have to say this, the states of Georgia and Alabama, obviously need to be prepared. Some of the hurricane force winds are going to go well inland, well into the state of Georgia if it continues on the current track. So you're going to see a lot of debris. You're going to see a lot of power outages. With power outages, everything then becomes compounded. Our wastewater and water treatment plants are now affected. Our supply chains are affected. So we're really focused in on that. We're coordinating not just at the government level, but at the private sector level, so we can quickly and rapidly stabilize that. But it will take some time. Does that answer your question? Okay, thank you. Anybody else?
Is there any way you can reiterate, Counselor, what you said in Spanish? Because our company, Telemundo, is recording it. If you can reiterate basically what...
Yes, sure.
¿Algo en específico de qué?
No, en total lo que dijo el señor, lo que va a pasar por Georgia y los vientos y que no va a haber luz por un rato y que va a ser más fuerte que el flow.
Bueno, cada tormenta es diferente. Esperamos que esta tormenta traiga vientos de hasta 100 millas por hora, que pasen las 100 millas por hora. Entonces, también les pedimos a las personas que tengan mucha precaución con la marejada ciclónica. En lugares se espera que llegue hasta 12 pies estas olas. Entonces, poner atención a las autoridades locales es súper importante, ya que pues, si hay que evacuar o si tenemos que salir del área donde vivimos porque es peligroso, hagámoslo. Cada tormenta es diferente, pero continuamos vigilando esta tormenta muy de cerca para poder informar. Nosotros ya estamos aquí listos en FEMA para apoyar a nuestros socios estatales, también con la familia federal, como lo vimos, el Cuerpo de Ingenieros, Servicio Nacional de Meteorología, para poder tener actualizaciones y poder informar. Pero les pedimos que pongan mucha atención a las autoridades locales, ya que si tienen que evacuar, hay que hacerlo inmediatamente.
Any other questions? Yes, ma'am.
Are there any specific numbers of how many people have been deployed to the area, or what kinds of resources are already there?
So, from the federal perspective, we already have a large contingency that's in Florida from Hurricane Irma. We're going to utilize a lot of the staff that we have in place now, but we have sent our National Incident Management Assistance Team is on the way. Our Regional Incident Management Assistance Team is already at the Florida EOC. We have a pre-designated federal coordinating officer that's already at the Florida EOC, as well as other staff. We have our Urban Search and Rescue Network all on alert. We have teams that are currently in Atlanta ready to push out. As far as commodities, our stopgap commodities, which are not intended to be the primary source of food and water, but they are just as what we say, a gap measure. We have adequate commodities on hand in Atlanta, and we can push those anywhere in the panhandle. So we feel like we're very prepared for Michael. And again, we're supporting a extremely capable state in the state of Florida and the surrounding states. Any other questions? Well, look, in closing, I want to thank the media. You are our biggest voice at this time to get the message out to the citizens. I urge, again, our citizens on the Gulf Coast to take precautions. If you are under an evacuation order, please evacuate. And, our thoughts and prayers will go out for everybody affected by Hurricane Michael. Thank you.
Thank you all for joining us today. As a reminder, if you haven't already done so, download the FEMA app to get up-to-date information from FEMA. And we do plan on having a telephonic update today at 3:15, and again, another press brief tomorrow morning at 9:15. Thank you.